Now, the eagle-eyed among you may have noticed that we are no longer anywhere near Soltis, and there is what appears to be a giant looper floating around down there. Yes, there is a giant looper ship battle. And yes, before we go to Soltis, that is terrifying. Before we go to Soltis, we're taking this guy on. And we're going to clear up a lot of optional bosses and stuff like that we hadn't done. Because once we go to Soltis, there isn't really much to do. There can't go back and do a lot of stuff. Now, like all loopers, this guy has a chance to run away. So, I want to make sure I do. Make sure that I focus a lot. He'll only run away if he takes too much damage in one turn. So I want to make sure I focus a lot and I throw everything at it when I get the Moonstone Cannon turn. There's gonna be a lot of focusing going on. Also in this area, which is affectionately known as Looperland, you can grind loopers who drop the black map, and they can stop enemies from it randomly appears. They can randomly stop enemies from running away. See, there's my big bombardment turn that I want. Yeah, the black map stops enemies from being able to run away, which is very handy. Because there is another looper boss that I want to take on. And we'll have to go back into the Dark Rift to do it. Torpedoes away! Okay. I can't use a cannon there because we're using the Moonstone Cannon. Can't can't use the 5-inch cannon. There. If this doesn't work, you know, we're kind of boned. They're pretty evasive as well. Does a fair whack of damage, I gotta admit. Honestly, I don't think I could have bombarded it with anything else. Oh, the poor thing is quite clearly in a lot of pain. Yeah, there we go. Boop. Yeah, pretty nice. Oh, 13,000 gold, 7,000 experience. Another captain stripe. So yeah, around here somewhere. I don't think I can see it now. I think I'm too far away from it. At the tip of this area is the Looper's Nest discovery. Okay. So, let's heal up the ship. First of all, let's apply the Captain's Stripe. I'll do that through someone else's items, don't I? Come on, Chris, get with the program. Two Captain Stripes to apply. There we go. Of course, because I've defeated the Hydra. What else did I get from it? Got a Shredder Bomb. And I also got the Hex Shell. Nice. So our next port of call is going to be the Dark Rift. So it's going to be a lot easier for me if I go northwest from here and utilize the fact that the world is round. It does seem trite to go and do all this stuff when the world's in danger, but, you know, they understand. It's like playing, you know, any sort of RPG with a lot of side quests in it. You gotta go save the world. Well, not before I do all these quests. So I've got Vyse using the black map already, which stops things from being able to run. Okay. Pretty much getting a little patchy in places. See if I just carry on this path. I mean, the sky's frame rate is a little patchy. Everything else seems fine, you know. Here I am. With a ship that's moving fairly nicely. That's Ryukan's island we just went past. It does take quite a while to get anywhere in this game, doesn't it? Dark Rift. Where is the entrance or the exit? Come on. Here, portally door thing. Maybe it's easier to see from the right level. I think of where I came out. So maybe through here? Nope, I can't get through there. this way. Up over here. Suppose I did come out on this side, didn't I? So it was probably on this face. There it is. So into the dark rift. Not a healing thing, a saving. A save point. Somewhere around here. Isn't there? Turn around. No, there is not. Oh well. I'd better not die then. To be honest, most of what it does is going to be magic. What do we got in here? Oh yeah, these guys. Some really annoying stuff. Counter everything, please. Go up. I can't remember what level I was when I first came through here. I wonder what level I have to be to have enough spirit to start off with Rain of Swords. Yeah, you can't run. Black map, motherfucker. Oh wow, Fina can't even kill it in one go. Guess we're not that high level. Oh, hi Edgar. Doing twice as much damage.
An utter victory.
Yellow rank up. Does that mean Fina is now maxed out on yellow magic? Nope, not yet. Aye. Ah, there it is. Ah, and our save point. Let's utilize the save point, please. Where'd he go? There he is. Hello. That was an interesting animation. Also, note that he is now no longer anywhere near as large. Okay. Delta shield up, and we'll focus. Okay. Okay, I did not see that coming. That thing's quite strong. Huh. Jeez, that thing is very strong.
This should work.
Okay, this guy's gonna be a much tougher fight than bloody Galcian was. Just a shield. Thankfully, it's decided to turn around and use magic. I didn't realize it hit that damn hard.
Let's try this.
Okay. This thing has a lot of defense. Focus. Delta shield. I'll use a curious crystal on you. Just a shield. Okay, I am in for a really big roll of hurt.
Let's try this.
Tried to run.
Here goes.
Let's try this.
Of course, what's worthy of note is that you can only fight Elsian after fighting Galcian. He's also yellow affiliated. Okay, if I use Pirate's Wrath now, I'm not going to have a chance to use anything else. I need 6 spirit to use, Delta Shield, and just a shield together. Probably should have had Vyse use a glyph of might actually instead of focusing. Okay, so he's trying to run again, that's fine.
Hmm.
Glyph of Might. Delta Shield. You can continue to focus. Get some strong turns in. There's a skull shield in use for this. Don't think it's any better or worse than thingy-majig. Just a shield. The only difference between it is that with skull shield, you automatically counter. That's a bit more like it. You're not going to get a chance to run away. That will put him in the guard stance, which lowers the amount of damage I do. I do have an aura of valor that I could use to boost my spirit right up to full, but I kind of want to hold on to that one. You know, the whole, you know, last bosses and all that stuff to come. Might do another turn of focusing. Just drop Pyro's Wrath on it. No. Hopefully it doesn't try and run, because that's just really going to irk me if it does. I don't mind the trying to run so much. It's just the fact that it puts it into a guard status. Come out and face me, you stupid looper. There we go. Now I can skip it again. We know he's not going to guard, which is a good thing. Yeah, I like it. It's a pity that I'm not going to get to do any focusing this turn, but we should be fine. As long as he doesn't crit Ike again. Oh, what? Okay, okay, I didn't know he could heal himself.
Here goes!
At least Sakura's only heals 1,000. I'd be really fucked off if he used Sakura. The instant focus and unleash prophecy. The fact that its crits still do like 2,000 odd damage even with just a shield on it. Jeez, you know. Use just a shield and guard on the same turn and just really take like no damage whatsoever. Oh come on, really? You're guarding on this turn. So close. Kill magic. Okay, it's in a guard phase this turn anyway. A guard phase. Damn it. No, he's just not getting away, you know, there is always that. One more pirate's wrath, one more pirate's wrath, and it's done. I know I said I wouldn't. Kinda glad now that I have to do more damage to it. Please be enough. Yes! Take that, you looper. Excellent. Well, and that's the Black Looper defeated. Where's my save points behind us, isn't it? There it is. Well, there's as good a place to leave off as any. We'll see you next time for more world boss clearing in Skies of Arcadia Legends. Thanks very much for watching, folks. Good night.